Hey y'all, this is Becky and Chris with the Glitter Ranch, and we are going to epoxy some tumblers today. I'm going to teach them how to use the epoxy method, and we're going to do a beach tumbler. Thank y'all for joining us. Hey y'all, okay, we're back. So we have our cups already on the turner, the one that we painted the other day. I want to tell you the colors that we're going to use. Okay, I'm going to do mine in holographic. Chris is going to do his in metallic. Mine is Penny Holographic, Angel Dust Mirror Fine, Shipwreck Holographic, Blue Lagoon Holographic, and Patriotic Holographic. All Glitter Ranch glitters. For Chris's, for the metallic, we've got Vacay, Pearl, Shipwreck again, but in the metallic, not the holographic, Azure, and Patriotic. So you can find all of those at theglitterranch.com. I have already mixed equal parts of epoxy. We're going to do the epoxy method. I guess maybe I'll just show you how I'm going to do it and then let you do it as well.
Oh boy.
So we have gloves on. Always wear gloves. I'm wearing his gloves because I ran out of my size gloves, and he bought like a box of 200,000 or something. So I have my ponytails on my wrist. So there you go. I guess I could have brought you a little cup, but I did not. I brought one thing of epoxy. So there you go. Just, you know, apply it. It's just gonna go on the cup. You wanna get it before it runs if you can. The point is just to get it all over the cup, but you don't have to have a ton of it where it's dripping off after we get it applied all around, because we are going to be covering it with glitter, and your glitter will tend to shift around sometimes if you have too much epoxy. You good?
Slowly.
You can always dip your finger in and use that. Oh, I thought I was going to dip into yours, not
something. That knocked it out of my hand. I didn't have a good grip on it because I was trying not to squeeze it too hard.
Yes, there's no right or wrong way to do this.
Because if there was a wrong way, I would be doing it.
Yes, that's the wrong way, whatever it is. See, it's not too bad. You feel like you've got plenty on there and you've got like kind of some extra thick parts, you can always scrape it back into that cup. We are in the garage, not in my shop. Typically, my extra I'm gonna make a keychain out of or mold of some sort. You can see the bottom of our cups are still taped, and after we glitter, then we'll come back and remove that. Good. If you have any bubbles in your epoxy before you start, you know, it's not really a big deal because we're gonna put glitter over all of this. So any of those little discrepancies that you typically would not want will not matter at this point because, you know, we're at the base coat. Just like the spray painting, it's okay that it's not perfect because it's going under everything. I would highly recommend, if you're doing this, that you're wearing a mask. Of course, we're in the garage and filming. Otherwise, I would be, I always do. I do not like the smell of epoxy, even if they say it's non-smelling, non-toxic. I seem to
I don't smell anything.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, just for even purposes, let's go ahead and drag it up.
I have been. See, told you I was doing it wrong.
I'm just going to smooth you out because I can see just from where I'm at. And with the filming and, you know, being an awkward
spot.
Yeah,
I can see yours is smooth and mine's not. Why?
It's okay. Well, I've already stopped, so it's self-leveling. So it will kind of you know, fix that. It's okay, that bubble doesn't matter. When you pop something in the middle, I always like to give it a whole brush over again, just so there's not that trail left from doing it. But yeah, see, yours is smoothing out just fine. Some of it will be the heat from, you know, just naturally the ambient heat. Okay. All right, now, before you touch all my pretty little glitters, I'm gonna give you a wet wipe. The wet wipes are great to have on hand to clean up, or the paper towels or whatever. So go ahead and kind of get that off so you're not contaminating my bottles so much, please, sir. And you want to be careful to not get any little hair particles from your wipes, your paper towels, whatever, into your epoxy. Just, you know, more preventative you can be, the better it is for you later. Okay, so that comes off pretty easy. So let's get to glittering. Now you can hear my tumblers wanna make their little noises. Okay, so let's start with the bottom. Let's start with your gold that you got over there. You'll be with Vacay and I'll be with Penny.
Okay.
This seal may not even be completely off. Yeah, here, I'm gonna get that for you. Okay, you can do this any way that you would like to. Again, if you see my other videos, I like to take off the lid and pretty well just control it that way. If that's not your thing and that's not going to be his thing, we're going to say you go light with the with this, because you can always. So all of our glitters, like I said, they do come with the larger lid or the holes in them for your glittering.
Yeah, because I'm going to treat it like my brisket seasoning and dump it on heavy.
I'll just go with light. Okay, so what we're going to do, ideally, is we're going to, yeah, I've got your plate there. You want to have something to catch your glitter so you can, of course, not waste it and put it back into the box is the idea, or the bottle, rather.
So how far am I going to come up with this gel?
Okay, I tend to like to just hit kind of the bottom part. So if you will just kind of tap the bottle, there, it's just kind of coming out nice and easy. You can always add more, but you can't take away. So the easier you go in the beginning, the better. Okay, it doesn't have to be perfectly straight because it's a beach is what we're going for, kind of that look, okay? And when you lift up from your cup, you're going to get a lighter little dusting. It's going to be total preference, okay? Closer you get, the more it comes out. You really can't smell that epoxy?
Not at all.
That's awful. And you're just going to want to go around a couple times, and then we can always come back later. No big deal. These beach tumblers have so many options on how you might want to do them and the look you might want to get. We can go back later and add acrylics. Okay. And go into another. You let it spin a couple times, kind of that excess comes off, or kind of tap on your stuff. So if you close your lid and then open it up, and you've got your plate. Plate helps a lot in funneling it back in. I'll be in the camera so I can see you waste my glitter and then fuss at you about it.
I don't know what video evidence of that. Thank you.
Nope. It's going down. And be careful about doing it over your cup, because if it brushes out, and sometimes it does, then kind of screwed it up.
Told you I could do it wrong once again.
Yeah. But you're doing great. Okay, then go ahead and like. That's why I have so much glitter on my legs when I come in the house, because I went like tap, tap, tap or whatever, because our next color is going to be white. So you definitely don't want to contaminate that if you can at all avoid it. So it looks like our beach sand is done kind of dropping off, so we're going to go white. So again, I've got the Angel Dust Mirror Fine. He has got Pearl. Sorry, I didn't open all of these. Well, some of them I did open, but I tend to just take the lid off and go for it, so that's why. Yeah, got it? Okay, so same technique. This is gonna be our water. It tends to be a pretty thin ring. Doesn't have to be. Totally your preference. I'm not good with being patient.
She's really not.
Oh, that's pretty. I like it. Yeah, I like to get my glitter on, but I typically don't do this epoxy method, and so I don't typically have to wait. I like the spray adhesive where I can get it on and get on to my next whatever. Gold came off. Okay, when that happens, that's fine, but it is not going back in that bottle because I don't want it contaminated. So I'm going to keep two plates. I'm going to keep one for my next color and one for my tapping of extra that's going to be mixed glitter that you can put in a dump bucket kind of thing. We have somebody that just wants something random. And you do have those people who will want that. So you're doing a great job. Okay. Are you happy with that?
Yeah.
Okay, I think it looks nice.
Thank you.
May I start selling cups, honey? Okay, so let's move on. So give me your two girls over here that you've already done. Okay. So like I said, I have done Penny and Angel Dust Holographic Fine. Both of mine are holographics. Chris has got metallics. He has got Vacay and Pearl. Next, let's go Shipwreck. These are both Shipwreck. This is in our Holographic Fine and the Metallic Fine. And when I say fine, I really mean ultra fine. They're all 1/128 cut. So, let's get after it. Okay, so for our next video, I will pop out all the plastic, all the sealers. Sorry. Okay, here's everything. Yeah, that little guy worked good. Pop these sealers out. I like to go kind of a little thin on my first color. Look at that, slipping right off. Okay, and then I go a little thicker on the other blues. Total up to you, no wrong way to do it. Just be as creative as you want to be. I was watching one of Marshall's videos the other day. Marshall made, and he kind of starts off here and then comes in, and somebody was asking why, and it kind of helps get your glitter kind of to the edge of the bottle so it can start coming out how you want it, kind of get your flow ready. So, love it, love it. Okay, so before I tap, we're gonna let it run around just a couple times. And then we'll go ahead and pour back in the bottles. And then I'll get our other plates to tap off. That way anything that wants to come off can get right back. So pretty. Now you can use plates. A lot of times I'll just, going through the store and they have some kind of crazy plate on clearance for whatever season, a lot of times I get plates like that. Okay. Get on clearance or whatever. Okay. Nice. And you can see there's a couple places that kind of have a slick spot, and that's where they could use more glitter, and we'll go back in and do that. Okay, so we're gonna use the lighter of our blues, of our next. Are you good?
Okay. Yep.
All right, let's do it. I popped my little thing off a while ago. I was waiting to do something. Okay, so keep in mind we have this color and one more. You can always add more, but just, you know, be aware whatever your design is, whatever you're doing, might affect how thick you want to go on this one. Again, total personal preference or whatever your customer is wanting. I like to go back on my beach cups and either do some acrylic or micas, just to kind of give like a little bit of a cloudy look over. We'll epoxy this, and then like on the next layer, I think it just gives a lot of depth to the cup. I heard someone saying the other day on a video something about using the holographics only as the tacket method, and honestly I use holographics all the time just like I would my regular metallic glitters. I love the tacket method. I think it's beautiful with the holographics, but it's certainly not the only way you can use them. How you doing?
Okay.
Yeah. So see right in here, I'm not sure if the camera can see that, but in between these, mm-hmm. those little slick spots, we'll just go back and get those with another coat. No big deal. No big deal at all. It's pretty. I like those colors. These are a little, our colors are a little bit different, but so close. Looks super beachy.
I'm not beachy.
You do look beachy. Beach it up, honey. We should go to the beach. I think one of our next blue glitters we're going to name Bora Bora. Watch out, watch out. Tap on you.
I'm not tapping on
me. All right, give me a clean.
I have enough random glitter on me as it is now.
I don't believe that for a minute. We can make a little song. Started. Sometimes that happens when you move stuff around and they're not in a regular space.
Or you got a ham-handed man out here working on stuff.
Well, yeah. Or you're on camera, then you know what can go wrong does go wrong kind of thing. Okay, so just to recap, if you're just joining us, I have Penny Holographic, Angel Dust, Blue Lagoon, Shipwreck, and now I'm about to add Royalty. All of mine are metallic, ultra fine. You go ahead, baby.
Mine are metallic. You're
holographic. Mine are holographic, ultra fine. 1/128 cut. Chris has got all metallics. He has vacay, because it looks like a vacation that we need to go on with these cups. Pearl is the white. Shipwreck, he is in metallic again. Mine's shipwreck and holographic. Azure is the lighter blue, and now he is on patriotic. This is his first time to do a cup, so the whole point is just to kind of show you, you know, it's great when you watch those videos of the people that have been doing a long time, and you think, how am I going to figure that out? But I mean, it's really doable. He has never made a cup. He has watched me on the camera in my shop make a cup, but...
Parts. I've never watched the whole thing.
Why, am I boring?
No, I'm not crafty.
Right.
We all know this.
Well, you know, honestly, you're doing really good. And honestly, your cup looks better than some others that I have seen. So, you know, you've got a new job now. You just thought it was shipping. Turns out, it's cup. You get to decorate.
I don't think I like this idea.
No?
No.
Then maybe you probably shouldn't have done so good today. That really looks good. All right, so that's really the gist of it. these cups will need to turn. I actually have timers on all my turners because if I set it and forget it, I'm literally gonna forget it. So that works best for me. Not something you have to do. You can, I guess, leave them spinning all night. Just less motors to replace in my mind if I'm only utilizing them as needed. So we will leave these spinning. Ooh, let's leave it spinning just another minute and then we'll take our tape off.
Well, I've got to redo some of mine right here.
Okay.
Do I got to do that now?
We need to do it while, but wait, don't put that glitter over the other glitter.
I was going to put up my blue first. Okay. And then get out my shipwreck.
Yep. Yeah, as that glitter is settling down into the epoxy, you may see that you need to go back, and that is typical. Honestly, that's why I typically do not do this epoxy method. Like I said, I spray adhesive and then I'm done a lot faster. To me, but this particular style cut really
more forgiving for me.
I'll just hit them all again with you. You're on the end. Let's just run through them again real quick. I do see a little bit. Then maybe tonight or tomorrow I'll run it out. I'll put a clear coat over these because that's just like the initial layer that we did. Real simple. And then we can go back and put the acrylics in. Do a video with that, with putting the acrylics on. Constant battle since we're on camera, keeping these cups aligned.
I'm wondering if I was taking over to the wrong side.
Hmm?
I almost opened the wrong side and started dumping.
Oh.
That would have been bad.
Well, honestly, there wouldn't be a whole lot that would stick because it's either down in the epoxy or ready to fall off. So that wouldn't have been bad at this point. Now, the first layer, it would have been bad. I really like doing these with alcohol inks just because I can manipulate the waves and stuff. I really like that.
My gold fell off of this wad again.
Okay. And rather risk contaminating, we will put it in. Okay, so there's some kind of weird noise. Not sure if you're hearing that. I think it's just the neighbor kids playing. Quite a bit of extra. So shipwreck, we're both doing shipwreck. Mine is in the holographic, Chris is in metallic. Get on the second layer, you can be a little more free because you already have your base down. You're really just trying to fill in any blanks. So you almost do kind of need to cross the edge a little bit because that tends to be where the slick spots are. One of us didn't. I think mine switched.
Mine didn't.
Okay. And sometimes they do, and sometimes they don't. It's kind of quirky. Ooh, that breeze is coming in and blowing my glitter. I don't feel it on myself, though. This color. This and Out to Sea. Out to Sea is very similar to this color, just a smidge darker. I love them both. In the shipwreck, we also do have it in the metallic chunky. I'm sorry, in the holographic chunky. This as bad as you thought it would be?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, it's crafty. Not my thing.
But what about difficulty?
No, it's easy.
Just tedious and time consuming?
Yes.
Not brain surgery though. I mean, once you kind of get the feel of the glitter coming out of the jar, it's really not.
Yeah, but we all know I'm mechanical, not crafty. I generally build the turners and take care of that kind of stuff and change out motors and whatnot, and she does all this.
Well, you're doing good. This second coat is looking so much better. Honestly, I was a little worried about your first coat. This coat, no.
Yeah, it does. Good. I agree. It looks a lot better. I did see the slick spots once I got the going.
Glitter makes everything look better. Nice. Yeah. We're going to sell your cup. How do you like that?
Okay, because I'm not going to use it. It's a glittery girl tumbler.
I'm sure there's some not my cup of tea.
There may be, but not me.
Oh, I've got a hydro dip something, so maybe we'll do that later. Okay, you know, we're having a cold front now, it feels like. It's probably 90 now, but.
Way cooler than I believe it's still in the 80s. It was low 80 this morning.
Hey, don't just dump your butter.
I thought my top color looked okay. It didn't really need anything else.
I feel like I just maybe just match. Sorry, I need to move here.
Excuse me, ma'am. Stay in your lane.
Somebody has to keep your cup on the turner. It's looking great. Yeah, no, way better. Like I said, you were a little slicky over there. Like the first coat really helps to let that glitter kind of settle into its spot in the epoxy. Second. I thought I saw a little something between your top blues, but you might have gotten it on that last one. Okay, so after you have applied all of the glitter that you want to apply, again, just let them spin. I've got mine set on 4 hours. Sometimes if it's super hot and I'm afraid the epoxy, or you know, if it's too runny, whatnot, sometimes I may set them 6 hours. I typically let them run for 4 hours. You can let them run overnight or what works for you, what typically works, and depending on your temperature and humidity and where you are and all of that business. Okay, last thing we're going to do is we are going to remove the tape. Need to be careful on this. I like to have the wipey available because your line perhaps could be an issue. You're not going to want to chase your cup. You're going to want to wait on your cup because you run on the risk, and you aren't going to want to do that because I've done it and it screws things up if your tapes come together. So once you get your tape, if you'll just kind of hold it and let it turn and do its thing, you tend to get a cleaner line because you want to pull it slow so you don't undo what you've done. You don't want to wait too long to remove your tape, or you're going to epoxy it to the cup. If you do that, and I have done that, all you're going to do is run an X-Acto along that line to score that and then take it off. So that's it. Thank you all for joining us. Again, you can check out all these glitters on theglitterwrench.com. Thank you.